What I've written, I have written. The peacemaker. Jesus should be king. But I want us to notice something in the book of John chapter 19. What book did I say? No, Mark chapter 15 and verse 29. Mark 15 and verse 29. Mark 15 and verse 29. It says, and they that passed by railed on him, wagging their heads, saying, ah. That's what it says in the Revised Version. But in the original it says, aha. It's an exclamation mark. It derives call and contempt. In other words, because of the Passover celebration in Jerusalem, and Jesus was crucified that week, Jews came from all over. There were many visitors from all over Palestine and from foreign parts. And as they passed by, there were individuals in the crowd who had not known Christ, wagging their heads and saying, aha, it's an insult of scorn, of contempt. Ah, away with him. There were those who did not know Christ, and still they did not feel sorry for him on the shameful, helpless condition that he was on the cross. And the victims were crucified naked. The artist paints a picture that Jesus is draped, but in reality he was crucified naked, despising the shame. Imagine the God of heaven, the creator of the universe, naked on the cross. He was crucified on the cross. The spikes on his hands and feet, the crown of thorns that ran through the cranium of his skull, and the blood gushed out, and the spear in his side. Despising the shame for you and I, friend of mine. We are nothing, we have nothing, and we give nothing. On the other hand, God is everything. He has everything, and he gives everything. Apart from Jesus, we are filthy rags. We are valuable, we are worth in the sight of God because of Christ.
That's right.
There is a fountain filled with blood drawn from Emmanuel's veins and sinners plunged beneath the flood. Lose all the good sins. There is power in the blood of Christ. God doesn't love us because we are good looking. He loves us in spite of, even though in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. When we were running away from him, he came looking for you and I. He loves us with an everlasting love. They railed on him, saying, ah, away with him. And the shameful condition that he was on the cross, covered with blood and sweat and spit, they spat on him. And Jesus died. And he was laid in a borrowed grave to the pity of a friend. There was an allegory that a preacher coined together and said that death and hell made a bargain. And death said to hell, hey, he's the grave. I'm going to kill him and you're going to keep him. And on that Friday afternoon, Jesus hung his head and died. And death said to grave, I did my part. You're going to hold him in the grave. Seal my tomb with Roman mortar. Get the woman out of here with a band of Roman soldiers. Guard the tomb so that he would not come forth from the grave. And Saturday evening, Sabbath evening, death came running to the grave and said, have you still got him? And death said to the grave, grave said to Mr. Death, I told you, don't worry. I got him, he's secure, he's still in the tomb. that because there's a rumor that somehow he might on the third day come forth from the grave. And early Sunday morning when it was still dark, Death ran to the tomb and shouted to Mr. Grave and said, "Have you still got him?" And Death shouted back, "Well, it happened like this. There was a supreme being who descended from glory with envolvent glory. And as he landed, he somehow had to put on his reverse gear because if he had not, he would have split this earth in two. And there was a mighty earthquake. And with one finger, he just rolled up with a stone and he sat on it. And the Roman soldiers fell back like dead men. I want you to know that the bigger the crowd is the greater the witness. Amen. I don't care what the devil throws at us. The majority has always been in the wrong, and the minority has always been in the right. Jesus says, "Straight is the way, and narrow is the gate that leads to eternal life." And that word for straight is not straight, but straight, which means austere. It means hard, difficult. Straight is the gate. Difficult is the way that leads to eternal life. Narrow is the way, and few there be that find it. But broad is the way that leads to destruction. Friend of mine, it might be hard, it might be difficult. This Christian life is not a bed of roses. We gotta develop a hard chair. Jesus didn't have it easy, friend of mine. He had it difficult. But come what may, we are not gonna bow, amen? Amen. We are not gonna sway with every wind of doctrine. We gotta set our face as the needless to the pole. We are not going to compromise with sin or the devil, amen. And there was a voice heard from heaven, "Jesus, your father called you." He got up and he just walked out of the tomb. And Grave said to Mr. Death, while he was walking out, he insulted both of us. He looked over his shoulder with all his scorn and said, "Oh Death, where is thy sting? Oh Grave, where is thy victory?"
Yes.
I'm alive, and I'm alive forevermore. We serve a risen Savior, friend of mine.
Amen.
He's in the world today.
Yes.
You and I can live because he lives.
He lives.
I can face tomorrow. What a mighty God we serve, friend of mine.
Yes.
He loves us with an everlasting love.
Yes, sir.
In Genesis, they call him Shiloh. In Exodus, they call him the I Am. In Numbers, they call him the Stein Scepter. In Deuteronomy, they call him the Rock. In Joshua, they call him the Captain of the Lord's Host. In Job, they call him Redeemer. In Psalms, they call him the Great Shepherd. In Proverbs, they call him the Beloved. Isaiah call him Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Zechariah said, "He is the branch." Micah said, "He is the one who is going forth of old. It's from everlasting to everlasting." Malachi called him Messenger of the Covenant. Matthew called him Savior. Mark called him Son of Man. Luke called him the Great Physician. John called him the Word made flesh. And dwelt among us and we bear his glory. The glory of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Acts said, "At that name, every knee shall bow, and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord."
Amen.
Thessalonians says that he shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. And we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord, what he said.
Amen.
Hebrews said, "He is the great high priest, who is touched with the feeling of my infirmities, who has tempted in all points like I said, yet without sin." Amen.
Amen.
Jude said, "He is able to keep me from falling, and to present me faultless before his presence with exceeding joy." John said, the Revelator, that he Omega. Amen?
Amen.
He's the beginning and the end, the first and the last.
Yes,
he's not coming back as a babe in Bethlehem or Judah to be spat upon, to receive a crown of thorns and spikes in his hands or feet. Revelation 19 says he's coming back riding upon a white horse. And on his tie and on his vesture it's written, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. He's the Alpha, the Omega, he's King of Kings and Lord of Lords, Friend of Man. I'm here to remind us as we face the new year with all his challenges and trials. He's a heart fixer. He's a man regulator. He's a bridge over troubled waters. He's a rock. He's a shield. He's a wheel in the middle of a wheel.
Yes.
He's a doctor in the sick room.
Yes.
He's a lawyer in the courtroom.
Yes.
He's a great I am.
Yes.
That I am. What do you say, friend of mine?
Amen.
He is Jehovah Jireh, the great provider. He is Jehovah Rapha, the great healer. He is Jehovah Nissi. Under his banner we will fight. Under his banner we will fight. He is Jehovah Shalom, the God of peace, what he said. We serve Almighty God. He's not just a rock in the weary land. I want you to know, friend of mine, he's not just a neurologist when you get a stroke. He's not just an ophthalmologist when you're blind. He's not just a physician when you're sick. He's not just a dentist when you have a toothache. He's not just a passenger when you're in a sinking boat. But I'm here to remind you that he's Adam Zudim. He's Abel's dignity. He's Noah's Ark. He's Abraham's sacrifice. He's Isaac's hope. He's Jacob's victory. He's Joshua's courage. He's Moses' rock. He's Samson's strength. He's Elijah's sight. He's Isaiah, Prince of Peace. He's Jeremiah, bones of fire. He's David's music, he's Solomon's wisdom, he's the great I am, yes. That I am.
Hallelujah.
He is the Almighty God.
Praise
he is God. The Prince of Peace, and he's coming again, friend of man.
Yes.
What a day of rejoicing that's going to be.
Preach.
He was born in an obscure village, the child of a peasant woman. He grew up yet in another village, and worked in a carpenter shop until he was 30. Then for 3 years, he was an itinerant preacher. He never wrote a book, never had an office, never had a family owned house. He never went to college. He never visited a big city. He never traveled for more than 200 miles from the place where he was born. He did none of those things one usually associates with greatness. He had no credentials but himself. He was only 33 years old when a tide of public opinion turned against him. His friends ran away from him. He was handed over to his enemies and went through the mocking of a trial. He was crucified between two thieves, and when he was dead, he was laid in a borrowed grave through the pity of a friend. I'm here to let us know that 2,000 years have come and gone, and all the armies that ever marched, all the navies that ever sailed, all the parliaments that ever sat, all the kings that ever reigned, have not affected life of man on this planet as much as that one solitary life,
amen.
The Prince of Peace.
Amen.
Napoleon, while he was in exile, said to one of his generals that Jesus Christ is the most influential man who ever walked upon the face of this earth. He said that Charlie May is Charlie Grady Kaiser, and even Napoleon himself said we have all tried to rule the world based on arms with force, but Jesus have established his kingdom based on love.
Yes.
Jesus have conquered the world based on love. He said, all our names will be forgotten, but the name of Jesus lives on.
Amen. Amen.
By his birth, the calendar is changed. The claims that Jesus made, no other religious leader upon the face of this earth ever made. He claimed divinity because he was God.
Amen.
I am that I am.
Amen.
In the Jewish mind, that is as high as you can go in claiming to be deity. But Jesus, he is the beginning and he's the end. And if God be for you, who can be against you?
Amen.
I don't care what the devil sends. He might interrupt. But he cannot alter God's original plan. God will have his way.
Yes.
We are not to be afraid because we serve a mighty God.
Amen.
And he's in the world today. Amen.
Amen.
My God loves us. What is it?
Amen.
Because he lived, you and I can face tomorrow.
Amen.
We are not to be afraid, friend of man. We are called not to be fearful because he gives us liberty, my brother.
Amen.
In Christ we are free.
Amen.
Amen. And the Son has set you free.
Free.
You are free indeed.
Hallelujah.
Fearless. Thank God Almighty. I'm fearless because of Jesus.
Amen.
January 1, 1863, when Abraham Lincoln signed the Emancipation Papers, ratified by Congress, of course, setting the slaves in America, giving them their liberty. And by the way, Jesus could not come before that. And the reason why, because the colored people were in slavery. They were not permitted to read and learn. And they had to be free before Jesus came.
Yes, sir.
It was prophesied. The great disappointment was prophesied.
Amen.
Prophesied again.
Amen.
When he came the first time, he came at the appointed time. When he comes the second time, he's coming back with catastrophic suddenness, ready or not. Here I come. We gotta have our lamps trimmed and burning.
Yes.
He is coming again, friend of mine. My God does everything on time.
Yes, sir.
When he said to his mother, my time has not yet come.
Mm.
When she said to the servants, whatever he said to you, do it. He does everything on time.
Mm.
My God is an on-time God. He may not come when he wanted, but he's always on time.
Right on time.
He's right on time.
Amen.
Not a moment sooner or later. We are not to go before him. He's at our side, amen, to lead us, to guide us, to accompany us.
Amen.
Let him fight your battles as you face this new year.
Amen.
Amen. He calls us not to be better than, but he calls us to be different from. Soon and very soon, for that man, we're going to see the King.
Yes.
You may die before you see the clouds burst and Jesus come with. But in his glory and the glory of the angels and the glory of the Father. But precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of the saints.
Yes.
We look for heaven whose builder and maker is God, amen?
Yes.
Whose architect is God himself.
Yes,
when he comes again, oh, I want to be in that number one, you say.
Amen.
Amen. I want to remind you that there ain't going to be no more sickness. No more pain and no more sorrow, no more crying, no more eyeglasses and no more wrinkles in our faces, no more false teeth and no more gray hair, no more arthritis, no more hypertension. Amen.
Amen.
No more AIDS, no more hospitals, no more prisons, no more death. Because when Jesus comes again, it's going to be all right. Amen.
Amen.
I want to be that number where it says, come marching in front of mine. How about you?
Amen.
Nothing in this life lasts forever.
No.
Salvation is in Jesus Christ at the moment.
Amen.
Buddha is dead, Muhammad is dead, Gandhi is dead, Aristotle and Plato and Socrates, they're all dead. The King of Reggae is dead, the King of Soul is dead, the King of Pop is dead. But the King of Kings is alive.
Yes.
And he's alive forevermore.
Amen.
The peacemaker is coming again.
Amen.
He is coming again. There might be somebody here, you want to make this your hope. You want to seal your decision. We do not know what the future holds, but we know that he has the future in the palm of his hands. Amen.
Amen.
We need to put our hands in the hands of that Galilean man who walked the dusty roads and the rocky places of Palestine. Everywhere he went, he was doing good. The blind saw and the deaf heard and the lame leaped for joy. And he's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore, amen.
Amen.
What a day that's going to be. May God bless us and keep us safe and keep us faithful of him, amen.
Amen.
If there's somebody here, you want to make this commitment, come with me. I'm going to hold on to Christ. Whatever the devil brings this year, our only safety, our only security is in the hands of Jesus, amen. If this is your hope, if this is your desire, friend of mine, I invite you to stand with me as we sing the closing song.